Hello everyone. I am Osman. It's nice to be here. Not here in the office. The office is empty more than a year, but I actually come to office to make this presentation. It's nice to be here on .fmp. I appreciate this kind of event that collaborates with user base around the world. Thank you, Egbert and his friends, for their effort to make .fmp even the current conditions. Thank you very much. Before I start, I want to talk about Metta. Metta is a kind of art performer from the 15th century in Turkish region. It's traditional art. It means a public storyteller. It was popular up to early 20th century. Maybe it's like today's stand-up shows. But Metta doesn't prepare in advance. He plays improvised. At the end of the show, the last sentences is always the same. Sorry if I slipped off the lip. It's the fixed, the last sentences. Let's come back to my spot from the 15th century. I don't speak English in my daily life, so I am not well enough about it. I want to say sorry in advance if I will slip off the lip. I am solving problems with my team at Cabitas, maybe you pronounce Cabitas, for a long time. FileMaker with me, more than half of my life, more than 22 years. I can't remember the exact dates, but I think I was middle school student at that time. The photo, there is a picture of me and our team from an event, but I don't want the photo is. Sorry. The photo is from a sport event, but I don't want to mislead you. I am not very well at good sports, only walking, using my fingers, or thinking is enough for me for my sport activities. I mostly live in Konya. You know, the Konya is one of the biggest cities in Turkey. It's good place for coding or file making. City of whirling dervishes. Today, I will share my experiments on importing data into FileMaker. Import and export operations are not new features. Even not feature specific to FileMaker, almost every database management systems or lots of applications has import and export options. Common usage of the operations, of these operations are maybe migrations, integrations, mostly. It's handy feature for all developers. Present a solution to for batch data entry into database. Avoid possible errors with the manual data entry. Boost initial data entry at the initial state when you start a new project or publish the new project on a client, on a customer. In some cases, the customer also willing to import files into their application, into their system. I mean customer, the end user. They don't know about the coding or FileMaker stuff, etc. It's not an unfair request, but there are some critical points. I say never trust the user. There is some reasons for that. Mostly, most of the users are novice. They don't know, they don't familiar with technology as we. And maybe some malicious users try to broke the system or broke the rules, broke the authentications. And also there should be, there might be unexpected events occur. So, according to Murphy, you know, anything that go wrong will go wrong. So that's why we don't trust to the user. I said it's not only about the user, it's about the, some cases we may occur, we may face with unexpected results for importing data or doing our jobs. That's why we are doing error handling. Yesterday, there is a good presentation about error handling. And we always want to make validation before making some operations, especially batch processes. The validation is important to keep your data clean. And better UX requires validations and to avoid garbage data into the system again. We generally inform user and get approval, the final approval from the user again to make something happen, especially again, the batch processes or risky processes, deleting records, replacing last of records or lines is important. So think like a Murphy, like the Murphy, and care of these subjects. Let's make it in a sample scenario. We have so simple order management system. Sales staff enter customers' information into the system. All staff workloads above the average for several months with the new orders. They have make overtime to enter orders into the system. There's a lot of work for them. The good news, their customer is also switched to the FileMaker platform. So they can send their order via email with an Excel file attachment in seconds. So a typical request from our client may be like this from our user. Our user gets the items, order items as an Excel file. He or she click create a new order form, and they ask for a button, import Excel file. He or she wants click that button and all the rest done. They ask request like that. It's so easy for clients. There are two-step operations, but as a developer, we should think much more. We can think for, according to previous slides, we want to make some validations and controls or cross-checks. So we should first import the course into temporary table. After this pre-import, we can make pre-validations, cross-checks, maybe cleaning of excess data. And finally, we can get approval from the user and move records to base the real table. Okay, this procedures, the scripts from this simple algorithm or flow can solve problem. We get the file, the records from Excel file to temp table. Then we make some validations. We clear some excess lines, the empty rows, or we delete and we show a report to the end user. if there is an unmatched or conflicts. After user approve the final preview of the import, it's okay. We get a happy customer. But maybe it depends on time. Some customer says, it's okay. I can import 10 or 100 records in shorter way that I manually enter it. But maybe it's still slow for the customer because some orders may be huge, lots of lines, more than 100 of 1,000 lines. So most of the customer clients are working on network environment with multiple users, even on the cloud. Our servers are mostly on the cloud. So these importing operations may slow again if the customer orders are huge or more than maybe 50 lines. Again, this is not unfair complaint. We can do better. Happily, we get a bunch of new features to enhance our solution. In version 13, we get performance singleton server. On version 15, truncate table help us. We can define external data sources dynamically with the variables since version 16. And lastly, data file script stack introduced in version 18. So these bunch of new features help us to make our solution better. First one, performance Python server. It's ultra fast record operations, but we should take care of or think that there is some unsupported script steps. We should consider that script steps, it's that step runs on server side or not. And performance Python server, we should keep eye on the context. I mean, if you start a script from a client, it runs without a problem. But the behavior is perform script on server is a bit different. At first, the PSOS script logs into file as a user, as a new user, start from scratch. I mean, like double click the application, enter the username and password. The first windows open, the trigger runs because the first window is trying to open. And the script will face with the login screen or the initial layout we prepared. So there is some details if we want to use performance Python server. Truncate table is faster than delete found records, but we have multi-user environment. We are lots of users, maybe at least 5. If you have more than one user, you cannot use a single temp file. Of course you can. Sorry, but you should keep which records, which temporary records is belong to which user. So in some cases, truncate table is not works for us, for us, because truncate table deletes all the records. But I want to delete only specific users' temporary record. Maybe this is an issue to solve. Next feature, dynamic external data source. There is a mistake on typing, not EDS, external data source. With the version 16, as I remember, 16 or 17. Never mind. We can define dynamic data source name with the variables, especially with global variables. So this brings some new opportunities. For example, in our case, the temporary file is only needed for the current user, not anyone else. So there is no need to send those data on the server. There may be similar use case. In importing case, we import our records into temp file, but we didn't check the records. We didn't check the consistency. So it's about the user. I don't need to send it to server. I can do this with my user file. It's located on our document folder. It is related with my main file, and every user have their own file in their documents. Placing file directly into user's computer solves our truncate problem. We can truncate records in every user since their own tables, own files for the temporary. This is another point. The last one is data bicycle steps. They come with the version 18. It allows us to export container data in server-side scripts. Now, we have some methods doing import process, import flow. My title was local import to remote file, but saying local import to remote file for the method, it will show some Angular or so technical, a little boring. So I gave it a name to personalize it a bit more. Remote is our name for this method. Actually, I previously used Kusos method, performs it on server for importing process before version 17 with the help of base elements plugin at that time. Last summer for a new project, I adopted user file approach. For that project, I say it remote now. The project contains large number of records and lots of users, more than 70 users at that project. So I think I will get some benefit from placing users on temporary file. I keep some user-specific data on that file. Also, I am using import-export operations as a temporary file. For this presentation, I make further workings and make comparisons for these techniques.
Can I ask a question?
So, yes.
I don't know for sure. I never tried it. But when you have a server-side script, a server-side script is able to open files on the server, of course. It's able to open files on another server, I know. Can it open local files?
No.
Can it open files in the data directory, for example?
No.
Have you tried it?
I didn't try it, but it is my computer, so server cannot reach.
I mean on the server.
Server documents folder.
The data folder on the server.
Actually, I didn't test it. I am doing Excel file, save as Excel in my computer and upload it to the server in the container field. I didn't test local FMP 12 file in server documents.
So it's worth trying this stuff.
Yes. The last time I tried something, on server side, an import you from a FileMaker file is still not working, but from a text file or from an Excel file, it does work.
Yeah, the problem is not opening the file. The problem is the importing.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, thanks. Sorry for interrupting.
The last method was not ready when I posted the subject line for .fmp. I add user file and PUSOS mix with the advice of Vince from Beeswax. Thanks to Vince. So let's go to demo. We have a method. We say the limut. Like everything, is advantage and disadvantage. I say it's sweet parts, the sweet side, and sour side. We may see now. I find this, I think, open here. It's my demo file. This is so simple order system. We are familiar with the automated spare parts sector. So I have some sample data of products. There is a code of the products, name, HS code, weight, and application info for this part is suitable to which vehicles. And also there is some cross numbers to define the same parts, because mostly customers doesn't familiar with our own code right here. They can ask their request or their orders with the more global codes. For example, Scania's code, Volvo says this is a 151, etc. It's a simple table. And another table is order. This is a so simple file for demo. I make some experiments. I click new record. I have an import button right here. There is some import options. First, traditional method. Actually, in the real system, user clicks the import button. And the script asks, where is your file, locate your file from desktop or download folder, etc. But I want to measure the duration of the process. So I select file selection dialog here. So the script doesn't prompt anything to the user. It automatically works with this example Excel files. First one is a small file, about 8 lines. I click traditional method. Sorry, I'm missing some error handling. I didn't select file, sorry. Start over again. I click import button, select sample one, and kick traditional method. The user see preview of the records. Okay, it's ready. There is only 6 records, but you see there is a progress bar deleting records kind of process, because most of the Excel file has some empty rows. My script imports records into temp file, and it's clear the unnecessary empty lines, and show customer the results. The customer, the user, check the result, and if it's okay, I click the import button to finish my import. Okay. Since I have a temporary table, first of all, my script go to my temp table, deletes all the lines or the lines belongs to me, my user. It takes 1 second. Importing new records from Excel file takes 2 seconds importing. And it makes some pre-processes. Actually, there is a 6 real line, but more than 90 line, they are all deleted in 8 seconds. And after I click OK, I want to import these records, it takes 3 seconds. This is so simple or so small file. Let's try it on PSOS. I click. Actually, I import records to my table again, my table on the server side. I make some operations, record operations, delete all records, check missing records or inconsistent records and clear them at the server side. And at last, when I click import button, again, my import operations is done on server side. It makes 1 second from 14 seconds. And I have some other options. Limut. The first version of the Limut is not good enough. Because again, some timely operations are done again in the my file with my user. When I click import, it makes import on my machine, send every single report record to server one by one. So it's not better than PSOS, but I have some gain in terms of performance from traditional one, 14 seconds to 5 seconds. The next one, I think importing from my local file to remote file, to my file on the server, on the client side, take a bit longer. I think if it's better with transactional data entry, with portal, but actually not. Limut 2 is doing import operations, not with the import command. It makes moving data from my temporary file to real file with copy and paste records with portal. I even done some optimization with transactional. I didn't send each request to the server. I make some batch, let's say 500 records. My script enters the loop, creates lines into the portal, and it only comments if my record number is 500. But it is not good enough. But it is again better than traditional method. And finally, I can show the last version of Limut. Mix of PSOS and Limut. It's much better. But it depends on our use case. What procedures do we have? Which pre-check should we do? What we will do if we have conflict? We may some extra replace commands or some extra operations. This affects on our results. I click import. In this case, for this small file, it's not better than other, but you will see with the large file, the Limut 3 is way better. It imports my local file, make pre-process in my local computer, then save file to the server, documents folder as an Excel file, last to the import operation. Let you sample 2 file. It is again a small file, as I remember, with 4 records. I skipped traditional methods. Maybe I start with limud. Oops. You see there's a long progress bar. This is what we face in many customers. Excel file has only 4 rows, but for some reason, there is some definitions at the bottom of the rows, maybe at the 1,000,000th row. So FileMaker is trying to import that 1,000,000 record. I click stop. So that's why we should consider limud. I can easily to drop operation. I don't know. I add allow user abort on option before the import for these cases. But if I didn't, maybe I make force quit to FileMaker. So with working with local file, it's an empty file, it's a dummy file. It doesn't affect on my database integrity. I skip second file. This is a bigger file. Maybe, yes, 90 records. Again, I make traditional method. Part. Sorry, I didn't create a new card, so it mixed from my previous order, but you see how it takes. I click source again. This is better. Only 2 seconds. And new record, new order. I run limbo 3. Maybe this is again not as fast as the Pisos, because in small number of records, Pisos is much better in my case. But with the, I assume the fourth file is a bigger, about 500 lines. Sorry. Click import with source again. I skip limud and limud 2 because they are not the ideal case. Okay, it's over 1,000 records. It's 14 seconds. Just try the mode 3 again. Click import. In this example, Limo 3 is has better score. And my last file is a bit huge, so I don't want to try it right now, but my previous try is here. It takes 4 minutes and 3 minutes and 56 seconds with the Limo 3. It's so similar, not to identical difference between two methods. These are my findings with this sample example. But I think it depends on the use case you are using. PSOS or Limoot method are reasonable. They all seem reasonable. I think you should make your decision with looking at the projects. What operations you should do, because some operations are faster on client's computer and some of the operations are better at the server side. Maybe server side is always so fast because both of the file, our new file, the file to import file, I mean the file I want to import is at the server, all the database in the server, so the interactions or controls over the relationships are much faster. But in other term, in other sites, my local file has some ability to make something faster, and it doesn't use server sources. It uses user sources. So again, you should make decision project by project, which is better at that time. This is my working and my thoughts about this subject. Thank you everyone that you are listening to me.